Hello, I'm Dr. Mikkel Jarman here with Pediatric Foot and Ankle, and today I'd like to discuss the topic of tarsal coalitions in the pediatric patient and try to educate you, the parent, regarding the clinical symptoms that your child would have and the recommended standard of care. Tarsal coalitions are structural abnormalities that form between bones in the foot that should not be connected, that unfortunately cause a rigid, flat foot. This connection can exist in three different forms: a fibrous connection, a cartilaginous connection, or an osseous bone connection. This condition is generally congenital, meaning we're born with it. However, it is noted that nearly 75% of people with coalitions have no symptoms and have no pain and need no treatment. When a child presents in the office, the initial complaint is a painful, rigid flat foot. When the child walks and stands, there is little motion noted to the heel. The child will always be pointing to the inside or the outside of the midfoot. Symptoms of pain will always increase with activities, and also it is very common for them to experience pain or spasms to the peroneal muscles on the outside of their leg. On physical exam, again we see a rigid flat foot with the heel rolling out, the midfoot collapsing, and the toes pointing outward as the child walks. There will also be noted a significant loss of motion in the foot. If we have the child stand and we look from the back, we'll also see that the heel does not straighten when the child stands up on their toes. As in a flexible flat foot, we will see the heels immediately invert. In the office, digital X-rays are an excellent way to quickly evaluate what type of coalition and the severity that exists. Radiographically, we are looking to see if there's a talocalcaneal coalition or a calcaneal navicular coalition, which happens to be the most common. Coalitions may not be obvious to some clinicians, so there are other radiographic signs and clinical symptoms that one needs to be looking for as well. However, I will always recommend that a CT or an MRI be ordered to fully appreciate the extent of the coalition. Most children respond great to conservative care, which is non-operative treatment. Initially, we need to calm down the coalition by simply placing the child into a boot or a cast for a period of time, then followed by a custom molded orthotic. This custom shoe insert stops abnormal forces and supports the foot. For children failing conservative care, it is recommended to consider surgical resection, as this will improve the foot function and stop the pain. Best results are always seen when the coalitions are resected in younger patients, as recovery is always faster. When resecting a coalition, this is done as an outpatient procedure. I will often place the child into a walking boot and allow them to weight bear the same day of surgery. They maintain the walking boot for about 3 weeks. Then I transition them back into regular shoe gear with activities as tolerated. I cannot stress how important an accurate diagnosis can be and how important it is for the parent and the child to understand the condition and the treatment options. If your child is suffering with foot pain and current treatment is not resolving their condition, please call today and have your child evaluated. I'm Dr. Mikkel Jarman. Thanks for watching.